This is Mr. His formal name is Hullabaloo's Mr. Bojangles. Mr.'s an old-time working-bred Australian shepherd and my right-hand man on my small farm. I think a person's really lucky if they can find not only the breed that suits them, but also the strain within that breed that fulfills their desires. I have worked and loved many breeds over the past 35 years, but find the working bred Aussie the ideal dog for me. I think my reason for choosing this breed has to do with the nature of the Australian Shepherd. Although the working bred Aussie loves to work stock and is very capable, his person is the center of his life. Aussies live to be by their person's side, helping out if they can. And I like that. As I've gotten longer in the tooth, and I'm a 75-year-old single woman, and am somewhat limited physically in what I can do, Aussies do about 95% of my everyday work. I usually run 50 to 100 sheep, 10 to 20 goats, and 5 to 10 calves, along with ducks, chickens, and guineas. I basically ask Mister to do three things: bring the stock to me, move the stock away from me, and hold the stock away from me while I pour out feed. He also watches gates, separates stock, loads trailers, puts the chickens up at night, and all the millions of things stock on a farm requires. Mister must use his brain to figure things out. I have no need for a push-button dog that has to be told everything to do, or a dog that you have to always have your thumb on to keep him from killing something. My dog has to be strong, yet gentle. I do not want my stock mistreated. I must be able to trust him out of my eyesight. Mister does his job while I do mine. His basic command to bring stock to me is back, or look back. To drive them away from me is steady, and to watch them while I pour out feed is watch them. We also have a language between us that has come with time and filled with strange noises that we both understand. Mister is often right when he ignores me, which is fairly often. He can read the situation much better than I can, especially at a distance. Then the working how-to part is up to him. He gathers stock on his own out of up to 15 acres here on my place. I usually go with him for larger pastures where he gathers to my four-wheeler, then we take him home. Most of my pastures are almost solid cactus, many places difficult to walk or ride a horse through. Amazingly, even when running to head stock, he rarely comes in with cactus thorns in his leg. On this video, you will see several different sets of heifers being worked in different situations. Notice how gentle they are. Mister has dog broken all of them, which means he has taught them to obey him. He does this by using whatever means he needs to use in the beginning to stop them from challenging him or running in my 200 by 200 foot pen. That can be his presence, or it can be a bite. Then when they stop and turn away from him, he backs off to let them know that's what he wanted. Most animals are more than willing to do what the dog says if they are controlled and not abused. And that's the secret, not abused. It doesn't take Mr. long, and the heifers do what he says, changing from tail up, terrified, running animals to trusting, gentle critters. They also have to learn to be close to a person in our area, as stock is not brought into barns, etc., and hand-fed through the winter. Often the calves only experience with a person one pleasant, like branding, castrating, vaccinating, weaning, and especially sale barns. Mister brings the heifers closer and closer to me over time, and they learn I won't hurt them either, so they settle down. Once this transformation takes place, most will remain gentle and easy to work for their entire lifetime, only getting a bit testy with a new calf. I try to take good care of my buddy. Even though he would go into a dangerous place if I ask, I try not to send him into spots where he's likely to get hurt, like blind alleyways where he can't escape, that are packed with cattle. I care for and depend on him too much to take any chances. Mister has raised the majority of my sheep. Like most Aussies, he does like to bring them in from the pasture a bit fast. For that reason, I do not send him out to bring in ewes with newborn lambs. He loves the babies and is very gentle. But if the mother wants to fight, he won't tolerate it. Ewes can injure a lamb by stepping on them when worried about a dog. When holding sheep away from the feed bunk, I often see lambs crawling all over Mister, getting their bottoms cleaned in the process. As a matter of fact, it is usually hard to get Mister to work the babies. Babies are not to be messed with, in his opinion. In general, the sheep and goats are very respectful, but they try him out every now and then, especially when trying to get to feed. He will nip them, but rarely pulls wool and never draws blood. When feeding several groups of stock, I don't have to say a word. Mister knows his job and goes from group to group, pen to pen, holding them away from me while I pour out the feed. I usually only have to show Mister new chores a couple of times, then he does it on his own. He always has an eye on me and always has my back. I don't have to watch and worry about a billy or ram, as he's always watching. I normally don't have bulls on the place, but imagine it'd be the same with them. Sometimes I trip over my own feet and take a tumble. When I do, Mister stops whatever he's doing and comes straight to and crawls on top of me. He's just worried, but it's kind of difficult to get up with a 45-pound dog on your tummy. Things don't always go like I plan. It's usually my fault, sometimes his. And sometimes I jump up and down and yell a lot. But at the end of the day, we're always buddies. Mister leans against my leg and looks up at me as if I were the finest person that ever lived on this earth. His reward for a job well done is an ear scratch and a grateful hug. Is Mister a perfect dog? Nah. But then I reckon he's not dealing with a perfect person either. We've a lot of miles under our belts, and we sure suit each other.
Thank you.
I made this video not so much to promote a breed or mister, but to show you just how useful a good farm dog can be. In this case, a working bred Aussie. Everyone wants something different from their dog, and with kindness and patience, most dogs with the genetic ability to work stock can be molded to suit those different needs. The best thing you can do when looking for a pup is to watch both of its parents work the kind of stock you will plan to work. Both is the key word. Don't listen to any excuses. If you plan to work cattle, both parents must have calm, walk-in strength on the head of a challenging animal. Challenging is the key word. Any dog can be made to look good on abused baby calves or take a fly-by nip on the head. You want a dog that has walk-in strength. Taking a heel is handy, especially in alleyways. But if the dogs won't face the head, you have no steering. A good dog is like a good colt. All need nurturing and training to reach their full potential. A neglected animal soon becomes nothing, kind of like raising a child in solitary confinement. You also need training in how to work and train your dog. You need to learn what is natural to your dog and how to use that natural instinct to help him learn what you want him to do. When it's all said and done, you will have a reliable buddy helper for around 10 years. After a bit, you two will learn to read each other's minds. And when that happens, working stock together will become amazingly easy and an absolute pleasure. That dog will save you a million steps, the money of a hired hand or two, and sometimes your life. When you get your pup, think of training him like you would a young child that doesn't speak English. You want him to learn to love what you two will be doing together. It is very important that he be successful on stock. This is a partnership for his lifetime. Let him grow up at your side. Do not let him get hurt or even badly scared. Remember, if he will be working cattle, it is a David and Goliath match, a 45-pound dog against a more or less 1,000-pound animal. He will need all the confidence he can muster. Always back him up. He needs to know he can always count on you. Show him over and over what he will be expected to do. Keep him safe. Go with him. You can do it on leave. Add a word when the action is taking place. Remember, we are not smart enough to learn to speak dog. He has to learn English. Then when he's old enough and mature enough for training, say 9 months to a year, either have someone start him for you or learn how to do it yourself. He will need to have a good stop, a command that means to gather the stock and bring them to you, a command that means drive the stock away from you, a slow down or speed up command, a call off command, and a bite command. It is also useful if he can be sent in a certain direction around the stock. All these things are learned by repetition. Farm dogs excel in everyday chores, something that doesn't change from day to day. Once they figure it out, normally it is not necessary to tell a good dog what to do. After a while, they fly through their jobs while you do yours.
Okay, mister, get back. Get back.
Just look how easy it is to have a good dog move stock through pens for you. Saves you a million steps again.
Come on, bud. Come here. Daddy. Daddy, come here. Come here. There. There. Good. There. There. Good boy. Lie down. Now.
Watch Mister ignore my commands here in a minute. And he's right. It's, you know, it can be humbling working a dog.
No. Away. Get back. Good. Away, away, right there, away, right there, listen to me, there, hey,
notice this pretty little Hereford heifer. When I first got her, you couldn't get within 100 yards of her, and look at her now. Look how gentle she is. She'd make an ideal mama cow. I just don't have any place to keep mama cows. It's almost, I feel kind of sorry having to sell her.
Lie down. Now. Lie down. Good boy. Get back. Away. Lie down. Lie down. Get back. Daddy. Okay, mister, that'll do. Come on. That'll do. Good boy. Come on. Okay, time to feed heifers. Watch them. Watch them. Feed trough is here. His job is just to keep him off of me until I get the feed out. Okay, mister, that'll do. Come on. Come on. Mister. Mister, that'll do. Come on. Mister, look back. Look back.
This is hard because I'm asking mister to separate two classes of stock in the pasture. And normally they give him a lot more trouble than they are here. But he brings the cattle in first, and then he has to make sure the sheep don't come in and eat the cattle feed.
Lie down. Lie down. Actually, he's kind of got the sheep trained. See them sitting back out there, not trying to get in? Now I'm going to open the gate. Lie down. Look back. No, look back. Right there. Right there. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. That'll do, Bubba. Come on. Back.
Mister's working a combination of ducks and chickens. And ducks work pretty good. They're kind of like a school of fish. One turns and they all turn. But chickens are just as likely to go the opposite direction than what you want them to do. And they'll squirt out. And they're harder to work, so the dog has to be really alert to do any good on chickens.
Back. Easy now, easy. Okay, bring him. Lie down. Okay, come here. Easy. Away. Away. Good. Good boy. There you go. Come on, that'll do. Lie down.
Just lately, Mister has started searching for lost baby kids. Boer goats are terrible mothers, and they regularly lose their babies in the pasture. In the evening, we have to go find them and bring them in so Mr. Coyote doesn't get any snacks. I showed Mr. once what I was looking for, and now he goes zipping across the pasture like a bird dog, checking all the wood piles when I tell him to look for babies. These kids are about 4 days old, and this is the first time they've really been worked by a dog.
Easy. Easy. Lie down. Lie down. Right there. Mister, mister. Lie down. Come here. Right there. Easy. Easy. Mister, that'll do.
Mister is also helping me raise and train a young dog right now. Cotton, formal name Sage Creek Cotton, runs out with Mister, learning to search for and pasture gather calves, as well as drive them away from me and hold them off of the feed bunk. It is always a good idea to have a young dog coming along, as accidents do happen. You can lose your good dog from one day to the next, especially if you work cattle. You should probably get your pup before your using dog is four. Remember, you can only let your older dog do so much of the training on a young one, because the pup will learn to mind the older dog, not you. Cotton will make a useful dog. He is strong yet gentle and has plenty of enthusiasm. Mister has given him a good start, but he still has a whole bunch to learn. I have been blessed over the years with many good using dogs. I could not have lived the life I live and have lived without their help. Each dog was unique and special and unforgettable in his own way. and each one took a piece of my heart with him when he left. My journey with Mister has been a good one. I wouldn't change it. I can only hope each of you find that breed and that dog that was designed for you. I wish you all the success and pleasure that working with a good farm dog can bring.